The interesting question is that we need to think of two different processes of toleration. One, the toleration of states tolerating religious pluralism, and then the mutual toleration of religious groups vis-a-vis one another. So this is the fundamental two tasks we have. And basically, the only way we can coordinate the two tasks is if we develop a global system based on three fundamental principles. One, religious freedom, precisely as declared in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, is a fundamental individual right. Not doctrines have rights, so the truths have rights, but error has no rights, but persons have rights. And therefore it is because each person has the right to her own religion that we must recognize each and all religions of each citizen. So this is the fundamental principle, the acceptance of the right of every human individual to basically find her own religion or maintain or protect her own religion. The second principle has to be a secular state that precisely protects the rights of individuals to their religion, to all religions. Therefore, they cannot privilege one religion over another, but they can also discriminate against religious citizens. So this is a truly a secular state based on the principle of neutrality, namely no religions to be privileged by the state, but also protecting the religions of all the citizens, particularly those of minorities, and this means protecting religious minorities from religious majorities. But the third and the most important task, particularly at the global level, is the mutual recognition of religions. To abandon the old concept of true religion versus false religions, heretics, schismatics, infidels, pagans, and idolaters, and to understand that today we are in a situation in which global humanity has to recognize that all religions, or each religion, has the right to be unique and different, while at the same time have the claim to be somehow valid, to have a message for entire humanity. So you have, it is in this context of mutual recognition. It doesn't mean that I recognize the religion of the other as being as true as mine, but simply one in which recognizes all religions, their value, that all of them have to contribute something to humanity, while nonetheless maintaining, perhaps, the particular allegiance to my own religion. Mother Teresa put it actually very beautifully when she said, I love all religions, but I am in love with my own. So it is this possibility of both, of having an acceptance of all religions, but of course, having a particular relationship with my own religion. Otherwise, we cannot have simply a viable global humanity. We are irremediably pluralists. We have to recognize this plurality as a fact, and the task is to convert this fact into a value. So it's not the search for unity, but the recognition of our diversity and our plurality, which should be the kind of the fundamental task of toleration.